Minister for Agriculture and Civil Supplies, Government of Telangana, to deliver his message. Welcome, sir.
My colleague, Honorable Minister from Government of Andhra Pradesh, Mr. Gautam. Honorable Member of Parliament, Sri Jaydev Galla, Dean ISB, Board Member of ISB, Additional Secretary, Ministry of External Affairs, Ambassadors, High Commissioners, and other distinguished members from the diplomatic and strategic community, senior officials, business leaders, friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen, very good afternoon and warm welcome to all of you. I am delighted to represent the Government of Telangana at this high-level dialogue on economic diplomacy. I congratulate ISB for successfully cementing Deccan Dialogue as an annual flagship event and, more importantly, for associating its brand with our Hyderabad. Distinguished friends, given the current international scenario, the theme for this dialogue could not be more apt. As rightly pointed out, no single country or stakeholder can adapt to the multitude challenges facing us. To successfully navigate through these disruptions, it is very important for all of us to collaborate with players at all levels in the changing dynamics of global economic governance. Fueled by rapid advances in technology, many new non-state actors are getting involved in the decision-making process. At the same time, state governments, particularly in countries with a federal setup like India, have a crucial role to play in enriching and expanding countries' economic engagements and are actively competing with each other in not only attracting investments but also pushing greater integration with the world economy. Government of Telangana has been proactively working on attracting investments to the state and, on the other hand, also encouraging the local industries to explore global opportunities. In fact, Hyderabad is one among the top 20 cities in the world which is successfully attracting FDI into ICT and electronic sector. In order to have a stronger connect with the external world, it is important to know our strengths and opportunities. In the context of my state, I wish to highlight some of the progressive steps that have been taken under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister Sri K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu. Understanding the disruptive nature of emerging technologies like IoT, we were one of the first states to come with a policy on Internet of Things, introduced in October 2017. It aims to create an atmosphere conducive for IoT-specific businesses and manufacturing units to thrive in the state. Recognizing the importance of promoting innovation and entrepreneurship, Telangana has invested a lot in creating supportive systems for startups through highly successful initiatives like T-Hub, V-Hub, Rich, etc. Very recently, we have also launched an angel fund called T-Angel to support budding entrepreneurs. To boost manufacturing, we are setting up a national investment and manufacturing zone in Telangana. This NIMS will be spread over 12,635 acres of land, and its first phase is expected to be completed by 2020. Telangana is known as the pharmaceutical hub of the country, attracting over 10,000 crore investments in the life sciences sector in the past 4 years. To further boost investments in this sector, our government is setting up the Hyderabad Pharma City which will be the first of its kind, smart ecosystem, creating a new international benchmark for sustainable industrial cities. The project will be developed over an area of 19,000 acres and is expected to attract ₹64,000 crores, almost equivalent to $993 billion. In the agriculture sector, which is my portfolio, I am proud to share that we have set many benchmark initiatives like 24-hour free power supply to the farmers, insurance to the farmers, which is locally called as Raitu Bhima, and investment input subsidy that is called Raitu Bandhu, which other states are now following us. With the successful completion of Kaleshwaram project, the world's largest lift irrigation project, our Honorable Chief Minister desires to achieve a crop acreage of 10 million will be realized soon. This will not only boost the agriculture produce in the state, but will have a multiplier effect on the whole economy. Friends, for all these initiatives to fructify and achieve the desired results, we fully acknowledge the need to build sustainable partnerships with the national and international partners. Hyderabad has many sister city agreements with various cities across the world, including US, Europe, Australia, and Asia. However, many of them are not functional, and it is important to revive the agreements, which I think is need of the day. Government of Telangana is also very keen to engage the Telugu diaspora into the state's development. We recognize the important role that the diaspora can play in strengthening our economic engagement and have a placed special focus on NRI issues. Distinguished friends, Telangana is ready to engage with partner countries within overall context of India's foreign policy and set successful examples for decentralized cooperation. With this note, I congratulate ISB and Ministry of External Affairs for partnering together and coming up with Dakkan Dialogue, and I wish the conference a great success. Jai Bharat, Jai Telangana.
Thank you, Honorable Minister. I request Professor Rajendra Srivastava, Dean ISB, to present a memento as a token of our gratitude to the Minister.